You get mentioned in my name. We don't like what you say. I don't give a fuck. You can suck my dick.
So we just looked at a couple of examples where data changes were enough to cause the statistics threshold to cause statistics invalidation, which then also gave us a new plan. And that seemed to be good. I mean, it gave us good information. But I did mention that in 2012 and higher, at least one row has to have changed in order to trigger plan invalidation. And that seems a little bit strange, but there was a reason for this. And it's to reduce false positives that some people get when they think the problem is statistics, and instead the problem is actually parameter sniffing that's become a parameter sniffing problem. So let me give you the scenario, and then I'll show you a demo on this to make this make more sense. So prior to 2012, or in 2012, if you know only a few rows across your database, and in some of your tables no rows have changed, you could still end up kind of getting this problem where users complain about poor performance for a stored procedure, and somebody during troubleshooting looks at the show plan and sees that the estimated number of rows is way off from the actual number of rows. And immediately somebody goes, oh, it must be bad statistics. Because statistics definitely have a bad reputation. And a lot of people kind of jump to the bandwagon of, oh, it must be the bad statistics. So then somebody updates the stats manually. And as I mentioned before, if auto-update stats is on and you update the stats manually, that will secondarily cause plan invalidation. So when somebody executes the procedure the next time, there's no plan in cache, which means one needs to be generated, and one's going to be generated by the new parameters being used. So those are going to be sniffed, the plan's going to be generated based on those values, and you're probably going to get a better plan. So the problem seems to go away, and you're kind of getting this positive reinforcement that updating the stats fixed the problem. But unfortunately, it wasn't the statistics change that made SQL Server choose a new plan, but it was because the plan got invalidated. So this is the false positive scenario that Microsoft is trying to move away from. And I get that, but it's only going to happen if no rows have been changed. So, it's not going to get you in the case where like two or three rows have changed and statistically your data really hasn't changed. If you update stats, it's still going to do invalidation. The only catch is going to be for the zero rows have changed scenario. So what it's trying to help us get to the bottom of is what the real problem is. And the real problem isn't statistics. The real problem is parameter sniffing.